Resources. Strong, I can just was mainly here just for the story side of things and like the co-op mission and stuff with some friends. Zones to get some better loot, which I think a lot of the end game content revolves around that, and just doing harder and harder tiers of like these strongholds and missions and things. So I was in it mainly just to do all the story missions and explore and stuff. Shot at a bird there. But yeah, like some of the people, like these flamethrower guys, have explosive tanks on their back. Some people will have, like, if they're machine gunners, big things of ammo on their back. And you can shoot that and, like, rounds start cooking off. Engineer and have some kind of techie backpack on that'll shock them. So, a lot of interesting things to shoot at. But yeah, I like this gun because even if I don't get that headshot, it still, like, does at least half their health. Was not a headshot, but it still put that guy down. I think the other one's just some kind of submachine gun, which I also like those. I'm not really a shotgun person in games. Stronghold mission is taking out the outcasts, which is just some crazy survivor group. Probably the craziest. They seem kind of like a weird culty people, and they have those people with the, like, explosive charges on them that just run at you. Just a weird street gang, and the Second Sons, which is seems like a paramilitary force. That was good. Lined up a few nice headshots there. So yeah, I like using, like, slower bolt-action guns, but then also not using them as full snipers. I just have, like, a little reflex scope on it. Yeah, a little bit outside the optimal range for that weapon. Why did they hang, like, shards of glass or metal? Level, you'll start seeing a lot of these, whatever you want to call the orange tier. I usually just call them legendary, working off of World of Warcraft terminology. You got your grays as trash, your greens as mostly Diablo. And I also like this little ability I have here with my drone that follows me around and heals me. Heals a bit slower than some of the other ones, but I just like because he stays out far longer, and you know, if I'm on the move, I pull out my shield, he's following me around. Got everybody to like 2 hits left, but we just mopped him up afterwards, so that's good. Some of the enemies have like remote control explosive cars and things like that too, which are weird and a little annoying. I think hyenas have the explosive remote control car, and I think this is the faction that has like a weird remote control car as well, but not explosive. They use it like a Beyblade or something. They just try to ram it into you, and it has like spikes on it. So I thought the strongholds were gonna be a bit longer than they were, but just take longer on higher difficulties if they just really buff these enemies. But each one that I've gone through so far only had a few bosses, and just took like 30 or 40 minutes to run through. Roosevelt Island, which I guess was at some point used as the entire thing as like a emergency hospital and quarantine place. So I'm not sure why you would want to use that as your base of operation. I would definitely not want to use somewhere where they were quarantining people after, you know, whatever big, I think it was a bioweapon in this one, but I wouldn't go near there. I forget how it works in this though. Maybe the survivors are the ones who are immune to it and not just lucky enough to have not gotten it. Some explosive. Oh, they're already planted. If you can hit that thing on their chest, which I missed horribly, but I'm usually better about, they will explode. Take out any of their allies near them as well. SMG here. Getting too close on us. Got a big sledgehammer boss over there, but they're super easy to just kite them by lowering them around. Sections of their armor. progress marker keeps on changing. Like, when you're inside, it tells you to go out there. But when you're on that side, it tells you to go back the way you came. So, we did a little back and forth. But, I don't know. I think it's harder to notice than it should be. See, now it tells us to go back. And I didn't actually see it on the way back that time. So it's not in this room. It is in this one on the far wall. But it seems like it should be obvious with me rewatching it now. But I totally just blew by that. I was like, it lets you go outside out here. Maybe we have to climb up something here. But, so, feel a little bit dumb about that, but when there's just a big hole in the floor over there, but I definitely wasn't expecting there just to be a tunnel in the middle of the tent, so I guess I was, I don't know, just not looking. As you can see on the map, this covers a pretty large chunk of the map, this stronghold, which is pretty cool. So yeah, but I've been leaving more stuff in series as well that I feel like I normally would have cut in the past, where if I just like fail something and have to redo it a few times, or I don't know, I'll just keep giving commentary through it and we'll have a good time. We'll laugh at it. So here we go. Someone finally stumbled upon it. So it wasn't just me either, it was all the people I was playing with here at the time. Randomly off enemies and can open those caches. Like, I've heard people pronounce that cache, but it doesn't have any kind of accent over it, so I don't do that. I guess it's the only point I was making with that. Essentially. And then like the yellowy ones, which are harder and usually have like physical armor you have to shoot through to start damaging them. Sure. sniper or a sharpshooter is a machine gunner's worst nightmare, I guess. That's what came to mind. But, because they can hit them from long range and, you know, they're not moving, they're just kind of, they have to be manning that station there. You. And when you're playing on a harder difficulty, especially if there's some level scaling, it makes it difficult. Because it's nice that the game level scales, but I think if someone's ahead of you, that though. It allows you to just jump in and have some fun with friends, no matter where you all are in the story. Another big sledgehammer boy. An ally in that telephone pole kind of slowed me down, but luckily we can take one sledgehammer hit on this difficulty, I guess. Someone's walking always right by. That machine gun nest, but I was going to use it, but then it popped up and said get off the ship in 12 seconds, so there goes that plan. Yeah, better to not be on that ship when it exploded like that. just gives you, like, proficiency caches of equipment and sometimes apparel. So some enemies spawned up there and got stuck, so we take some shots on trying to get them. There's, like, a very small window where you can actually, like, hit them in the leg or something. There was the bosses had some like different mechanics and stuff, where this one I don't think any of the named people really did anything special. It was just that that boat battle, I guess, was a little bit unique.